Hey everyone, welcome back to a new plugin showcase. Today we are showcasing Hunger Games, and this is a fantastic and a classic plugin to have on your server. You cannot go wrong if you're running a mini game server. So this Hunger Games plugin does work on versions 1.13 and 1.14. This is developed by Shane B. And then there is an older plugin that works on versions 1.7 to 1.10, but that is the only thing that it supports. So the plugin that I will be showcasing is developed by Shane B. So let's go ahead and get right into it. So we have our arena right here, and this does support multi arenas per world, so you can have a whole bunch of arenas per world. But the thing is that there's a feature called a world border, and it can be a shrinking world border, which is pretty cool, but it only works if you have one arena per world. So just keep that in mind if you do want that feature. So let me go ahead and do the main command, which is /hg, and that just shows you all the full list of commands that you will need. So we're gonna dwell on hg wand, and that will give you your wand selecting whatever arena that you want. So basically it's like world edit, so you select your first position down below and then your second position up above, or vice versa, however you want to do it. Basically you're surrounding your whole arena in a cube. So I have a warp set already, so we'll do a warp pause one, and this I just set previously before the video. So I'm going to come down here, so you come to your lowest position and go ahead and left click it. Now we'll set your first position. Now we'll go to my other warp that I set. This is pretty much on the opposite side of the arena and the very top corner, and we'll just right click it, and that will set our positions. So now that we have our position set, we can go ahead and create our arena. So we'll do hg create and then our arena name. So I'm just going to call this YT, and then the next space is the minimum players. So obviously you want more than just one, so I'm going to put 2, and then the max players for this one is going to be 12, right? So we'll do 12, and then the time, how long the arena sets. So I'm going to say 300, because that will be 5 minutes, but obviously you can make it 10 minutes, 15 minutes, however you want. It's fully customizable, which is great. So go ahead and just enter that command, and now you've created your arena. So now go to your spawns, and you can type in HG and add spawn. That is the only thing that you need to do, and then you just come ahead and go and add the spawns wherever you want them, and that is pretty easy. So just go around and add as many as you want. Even though you're adding specific spawn points, when a player joins, no matter the order that they join, it will randomize and put them wherever they spawn. So it will randomize wherever it is, so you don't need to worry about that. So now we can go ahead and set the lobby, but before we set the lobby, there is a chest refill option that we can do in-game. So we can do HG chest refill, and this will refill the chest, and wherever chests are loaded in your arena, it will automatically fill them with whatever items are in the config, which is great, so you don't have to manually fill the items. It automatically does it, and it automatically regenerates the world as well, which is fantastic. I really like this plugin. So we do HG refill, and then we'll do the YT, and then now we can set however many seconds. So the time has to be in groups of 30, so this is how much time is left. So we can refill it at 120 seconds, which will be 2 minutes left in the game. They will refill the chest. So let's go ahead and enter that. Now the chest will refill at 2 minutes when the game is about to end, right? So now we can go ahead and set this lobby wall. So we'll do warp lobby, and this will take me to my lobby location. So this is where all your signs will be located, and I'm going to give myself a sign. So to do the signs, you need 3 different signs. So just go ahead and place 3 signs horizontally, just like this, and then now you can just look at the signs, and we can do HG set lobby wall, and then our arena name, which is YT, and it will place the signs. All right, so we have Hunger Games, click to join, the status, and how many are alive or how many are playing. So now we can go ahead and set exit location. So when the game ends or when they leave the game, they'll be teleported back to this section, and then they can rejoin the game. So we can go ahead and do HG and then set exit, and that will just set the exit spawn right here. So I went ahead and just four-starred the arena just to showcase real quick. I will be getting some people from my Discord. If you want to join my Discord, it is linked down below. It is a community Discord, so you can get rules and advertise and all that good stuff. Now we have 25 seconds to roam around without taking any damage. So by default, this is how everything is. Once you set up the arena, you're pretty much set and ready to go. And here's the chest that you can do. You go ahead and just do all this. Now the game has started. We have a nice boss bar at the top, and we have PvP MP enabled as well, which is pretty cool. So you don't even have to worry about filling up the chest. There is a config that we can edit all of these things. So I really like that feature where it just automatically adds it, whatever's in the config. And a few things about the chest, there is bonus items that you can do. So one of them is shulker boxes. As you see, this is like a bonus chest. So this, it contains a shulker box, you can have trap chest, or you can have a barrel. So any of those items will be classified as a bonus chest. And I think I placed one over here real quick. I have to go find it. It's down over here, so we can go ahead and click on it. As you see, this is the other bonus chest because it gives you some pretty super OP items. So those are the bonus chests. Everything else is just kind of default items with armor and steak and food and pretty much whatever you want that you can customize. But that is by default. And there we go. I died. I fell to my death. And we get teleported back here. And it plays this really cool sound effects as well, which is pretty awesome. So no one won the Hunger Games arena. So let me go into the config real quick. We can change a few things that show the customization, and then we'll actually play a game. So let's go into our config, and if you guys need a Minecraft hosting website, go ahead and check out revivenode.com. You can use the code STRIKER in all caps for 10% off. That link is down in the description. Alright, let's go into our Hunger Games, and here's your arenas. You don't really need to mess with that. And then here are three different things that we're going to cover. So the main thing is the config.yml, and this is where you can enable and disable certain things. So if you want to disable mobs, let's go ahead and do that. Just change that to defaults. And then we have free roam time, so I'm going to change that to 10 seconds. We have boss bar, and then the max and min chest, depending on whatever it is. And then we have max team size. I'm going to put 2, because you can use the command HG team that will send a team request, which is pretty cool. We also have rewards, and then you're going to use commands and messages to execute. And then it also hooks on with the vault, so that will give you $500 cash. So you can also have a random chest as well. We also have rollback. So this is one thing that I want to change. So I want players to be able to break leaves and grass and all that. So I'm going to set this to true. Set that to true, and then now we can go ahead and break glass, and we'll do like oak leaves as well. So we'll do oak leaves, so players can be able to break oak leaves. And then here's the world border. I'm going to be enabling this because I only have one arena for my Hunger Games world. If you have multiple worlds and multiple arenas, you can enable this per world. But if you have multiple arenas per world, then this has to be set to false, or else the world border is designated for that specific world, and it will basically kill anyone that's outside the world border, even though they're playing on multiple arenas. So just keep that in mind if you want this world border to be true or false. All right, and then now we can go ahead and do the spectate. So I want spectate to be enabled as well. And then here you have a pre-made kits, which is pretty cool. So you can have multiple kits, you can have permission nodes, you have enchantments, and just custom things as well, which is pretty nice. I like that feature. So and now we have our items.yml, and this is basically everything within the chest. So these are all the different types of things. So I'm gonna change this down to sharpness 3, and then we can change that to like protection 4, and you can add names, custom items, custom names, you can add custom potion effects. So there's so many things that you can do with this plugin, and it works fantastically. So you can have like tournaments for Hunger Games, you can have custom items, custom abilities, you can do pretty much whatever the heck you want. So that is the items. I'm going to leave it the same because I like it. Let's go ahead and get this arena started. Now since we are in-game and we've enabled our border settings, we can do HG and reload. That will reload everything. Now we can go ahead and set our border if you did enable that. So we can go ahead and set our border center, which will be HG, and then border center, and then our arena name, which is YT, and we'll go ahead and set that location right here. Now we have a border size. So this will be HG and then border size. And then our arena name, YT, and then the size diameter of what it is. So this will be your final diameter size. You can have it shrink to this size. So I want it to be like 20 blocks in diameter, okay? So that will be the final size. Now we have a timer that will allow it to shrink. So we'll do HG and then border timer, and then our arena name, which is YT, and then we have the start, when it will start to shrink. So let's start it at 90 seconds. So keep in mind, this has to be in increments of 90 because that is how the timer works. So it's going to start at 90 seconds, so basically a minute and a half. And then now the ending time. So I'm going to end it at 30 seconds. So it will start at a minute and a half, it will start to shrink, and then it will stop shrinking when there's 30 seconds left in the game. So that is how that works, and now we go ahead and set our border, and everything has loaded. So if we do HD debug and then our arena, it will tell us all the specs of our things and see, make sure everything is loaded properly. So we have all the spawns, we have lobbies, the timers, we have our border enabled, where it is, and the refill and min-max players. So that is everything that is loaded. Now we can go back to our lobby that we made. So there is a way to get stats on scoreboard or holographic displays however you want. So I'm going to be using holographic displays, but the thing is, if you do use holographic displays, you do need an add-on called Holographic Extension, and that is a different plugin that allows you to use placeholder API within holographic displays, because normally you cannot access it. With the Hunger Games plugin, he does have it built in with stats with kills, wins, deaths, and total games played. So those are the different placeholders that you can use within the holographic displays if you do have the Holographic Extension plugin. But you can use it with scoreboards and also the normal holograms plugin as well. But let me go ahead and show you guys how to do that. So you can go ahead and just create a hologram. So I'm just going to call this YT. We're going to call this one Hunger Game Deaths, and this will show the total deaths. Now I'm going to go ahead and add lines. So there's the placeholder page on his wiki. I will link that down in the description. So we got Hunger Games, and then LB stands for leaderboard, deaths, and then here is the number one. So it will just put the player's name, and then it will be the placeholder number one. And we're going to do a colon. Now we need to get the actual player's score. So to do that, it is percent Hunger Games, LB stands for leaderboard, deaths. Then here's the stat, so this is will be the stat for the player, and then this is the number one leaderboard. So I'm going to change this to B, and that will match with all the other ones. So if we go ahead and enter that, it shows me my name, and I have the most deaths on the server. So that's probably not a good thing. But now we can go ahead and make the second place, and then it will be the second place player as well. And we go ahead and put that there, and then that is the second place player. So that is the first category, second, and then you can just go ahead and change the numbers for each one. And this works with kills and the games and everything. So go ahead and check out the link in the description that will give you the, basically you're just changing this to kills and then the place and everything. That is how you get the stats right there, which is pretty awesome. So let's go ahead and join a game. Alright, so we got some people from my Discord, and thank you guys for joining and helping me out with the video. So this first round is going to be a showcase of how everything works. We're going to go get the chest, and then we also have some kits, so we can do HD kit. Now we go ahead and just run straight forward here, get all the good stuff, and we'll see how it goes. So I'm going to run over here, so this is just kind of like a practice demo of, if you will, of the showcase, and I told everyone to be peaceful for right now, just for a few minutes, because I did enable the world border for this one, and we'll just go over here. So in the config, we did say we can break leaves, so we can now break leaves, we can break blocks, and that is how I set it up in the config just for this video, but you guys can mess around however you want. So I'm gonna climb up these right here, and now we can break the blocks because now we can go up and access to this top area up here, which is pretty nice. So I'm gonna come over here, get this chest, and we got a rod. So we're looking pretty good, and this is the Hunger Games plugin, and we have the scoreboard on the right hand side, and we also have the boss bar as well. So the border should be coming in. As you see, the border is over there. Chests have been refilled, and that works properly because we did set it at 2 minutes, which is fantastic. So I'm gonna head and go ahead and eat some mushroom soup. And the border is closing in, so that forces pretty much everyone to go to middle, which is how we set it up, which is fantastic. So now I'm gonna see my first victim, Yazer, down there. So now fight. Now we can all fight each other. So I'm gonna go down here, see if I can fight Yazer. I don't know if he saw me. Oh, there. Oh, yeah, it's a pretty OP sword. Let's see. Let's see. I'm gonna fight him. Let's go. Come here, Yazer. I got you. Oh, he has the bow. He has the bow. All right. He has a pretty OP sword. It looks like. It looks like we're killing him though pretty good. So oh, he has a pearl. Oh, oh, he died. He didn't make that pearl. Oh, he had pearls. Give me those golden apples though, and I want and let me get that. Oh, I'm pretty OP now. GG, man, GG. All right, so it looks like they're fighting over here, and it looks like Yaslo Let's see if I can clean. Oh, there we go. One hit, one kill. That is fantastic. GG, everyone. And I won the first round. How about that? All right. next round. All right, so now we are in the second round, and let's go ahead and get it. All right, so this is a round where just kind of go as you will. We have 10 seconds. All right, so I'm going to go with Luke, Ben, and Free Roam is enabled. Oh, is there anything in that chest? Oh, he's got a bow. I'm going to run in here. Hopefully he won't follow me down. Let's see. I don't even know what's down here. All right, looks like there might be some good stuff, maybe. It looks like it's nothing really, so it's kind of like a secret place. Oh, I see Luke Ben. He just pearled. No, he's getting away. Let's see. Oh, there's Larzy Boy. We can attack Larzy Boy. Let's see. Oh, he's trapped now. Does he have a weapon? Oh, I might die actually. No. Oh, I have to use the speed. Oh, that was so. Oh, he just poisoned me. I need to eat this up real quick. This is close, man. Oh, that's so scary. I'm at half a heart. Oh, I think I might die. I think I'm gonna die. No, please, no, I just died. Oh, that was GG. All right, now we are spectating, so we can fly around and find out everyone. So we got Slossy Fox. Oh, he was just killed by Yazer. A GG on that. Where does that arrow come from? Oh, he's sniping up there. Oh, Luke's way up there. Oh, looks like we got the final fight. Oh, this is a good one. I think Yalzo might win, though. He has that diamond sword and that speed. And it looks like it's gonna be... Yeah, he's kind of a... He's gonna get him. Oh, he does have the bow. This is an exciting game. All right, let's see. He's kind of bow spamming. Get him off of his tail. He can't really run anywhere because of the border. Oh, there's some lag. Can't really... Oh, there we go. That is the final one. So, GG to everyone. That was a fun game to watch and a fun game to play. So, huge shout out to these guys for helping me out with the video. I will see you guys next time. Peace.